What should we say instead of navel to spine? I wrote a blog post that used research to suggest that navel to spine is an unnecessary cue, at least from a biomechanical standpoint. So when we're talking about things like spinal stabilization and protecting the spine, navel to spine doesn't do those things. And so we can consider letting go of that cue if we're yoga, Pilates, or movement teachers. But then the question arises, well, what should I say instead of navel to spine? And so I thought I would just offer some of my perspective, at least, on this good question. And for me, what I would specifically suggest would depend on which way that you were using navel to spine as a cue. So in my observation, at least, I find that there are two different main ways that navel to spine tends to be used out there in the yoga and movement worlds. And the first way is navel to spine as just kind of a general cue peppered all throughout a yoga or movement class with the intention of reminding people to engage their core. So that's way number one. And then the other way that I see navel to spine used is more within the context of one specific yoga pose or movement. And it's usually like a core targeted movement. So within the specific context of that movement, navel to spine is often used to get people to activate their core more or more effectively or something like that. So it's basically, were we using navel to spine as more of that general peppering all throughout a practice way, or were we using navel to spine within the context of a specific pose for core activation? So let's look at the general usage first and what I would suggest for that, because like I said, it's different than what I would suggest for that other usage. So when it comes to reminding students to engage their core, when we're thinking about what to say instead of navel to spine, my honest suggestion would be, could you just say less? And could you just not worry about replacing navel to spine with something else that does that same thing or serves that same purpose? But instead, can we just think about the fact that our nervous systems do a really wonderful job reflexively and automatically coordinating all of the musculature of our core and our trunk for us? Our nervous system takes care of our core stability needs, and that's actually a really sophisticated, complex task. And we can trust our bodies to handle that for us without feeling like we need to constantly remember to consciously do it. And it's super unlikely that we would consciously do a better job than our nervous system naturally does anyway. So with all of that said, I feel like we don't need to think about reminding our students to engage their cores in that general sense, like all throughout a practice, just remember to engage your core. It's important to engage your core. That kind of approach is just not necessary. People's bodies will automatically handle that for them. So instead of thinking about what should I say instead of navel to spine, let's just think about letting that whole idea go and either saying something about something else, like just some other focus for that moment, or maybe just saying less. Because as with so many other aspects of yoga and movement teaching, it's often the case that less is more as far as our cueing goes. So let's take a look at this other way that navel to spine is often used, which is more within the context of a single core-oriented pose to get the core to activate more. So something like bird dog, which is this pose here where we're on hands and knees and we reach an opposite arm and a leg. I often find that navel to spine or something like navel to spine is cued there. And we know that it's really not necessary. People don't have to do that in order to activate their core. But we still could get them to tune into this area or activate this area, but maybe not with that specific navel to spine cue. So one approach that I like to take in my movement teaching is, and there are exceptions to this rule for me, of course, but in general, instead of focusing too much on how people are engaging their muscles and like where and in what direction and how much and which layer, deep, superficial, instead of me worrying about that for them, I could think instead of just cueing body part movement relative to body part movement and kind of use more simple movement-based cues. So where I'm actually focusing more on the movement than the muscle. Or another way that I like to, that I've learned to think about it, is to think about teaching movement from movement of the bones versus movement of the muscles. So if we're talking about bird dog, and if we cue, pull your navel to your spine, that's a very muscle-based cue. But if instead we were to say, pull your hands toward your knees and your knees toward your hands, that's more of like a movement-based cue, or more of like cueing from the bones. It's just asking the arms and the legs to move toward each other. And when people do that, their core, their anterior core, automatically turns on for them. The nervous system takes care of that in coordinating hands toward knees. So people don't have to think about the muscles. So we could think of cueing hands toward knees, knees toward hands, something like that. And then kind of hang on to that feeling that you feel as you reach an arm and a leg away from each other. So you can still find all of that good activation and arguably maybe, quote, better activation or more efficient activation when we don't like override it with super muscle-based cues. So just one other example of this would be supine core work. So lying on our back. And let's just take the example of like leg lowers. So something like this where we're lowering the legs. The intention here is to target the anterior core, like abdominals, hip flexors. And instead of cueing super in a super muscle-based way and saying something like pull your navel toward your spine, which arguably is not effective for core activation anyway that we would want here, we could let that cue go, but also maybe let most muscle-based cues go and instead cue from the bones by suggesting that people push their low back down into the floor. And by that simple cue and that simple suggestion of pushing your low back into the floor, you'll end up achieving all of this great kind of complex core engagement without having to think about it. Because that action in and of itself, that movement of the bones, will posteriorly tilt your pelvis and it will fire up all of your anterior core musculature. And then you can just tell people to keep pushing their low back into the floor, like don't lose that contact as you lower your legs. And that's kind of all you need to do in order to get the core to fire efficiently the way that you might want to in a movement like that. So there's much more that could be said. This could be a whole workshop, but I just want to keep this brief so it's digestible and watchable on social media. Let me know if you have any questions, and I hope these suggestions were somewhat helpful.